Well, Heather and Kevin, that claim you mentioned is 9 pages long, and it's filled with various allegations against Oklahoma County District Attorney David Prater. But the main reason for the filing, according to the document, Prater's former investigator claiming he was fired after he refused to continue what he claims was an illegal investigation. Prater, though, calling these allegations ridiculous and, quote, orchestrated because of a personal vendetta.
This is basically a whistleblower complaint.
Attorney Robert Gifford is talking about this notice of claim he filed in Oklahoma County Thursday on behalf of his client, William Mueller, a former investigator for District Attorney David Prater.
And it's for basically an improper firing, and arises basically from an illegal investigation.
An investigation that, according to the claim, Mueller refused to continue.
Mr. Prater ordered my client to obtain a grand jury subpoena to obtain financial information through Paycom in regards to criminal justice reform.
Mueller claims Mr. Prater, in his own words, felt that any reform to criminal justice was bull, and he was unlawfully seeking incriminating or compromising information about former Speaker of the House Chris Steele, one of the most visible leaders of the criminal justice reform movement in Oklahoma, and wanted to review donations from the ACLU to Oklahomans for criminal justice reform.
The investigation had no outside investigative agency. There was no case file.
And when Mueller allegedly couldn't find any wrongdoing through those grand jury documents, Mr. Prater became irrational and angry upon learning about the outcome. Mueller claiming that's why he was fired.
Client realized that that basically there was no probable cause to begin this investigation, and before you can ever request any of this information, you have to have probable cause. It appears that this was Mr. Prater's own personal investigation against what appears to be a political enemy.
But in a statement sent to News 4, David Prater says these allegations are ridiculous. I am unable to respond due to legal restrictions on revealing why someone may have been terminated. There is a personal vendetta behind these allegations. This was carefully orchestrated to be released during a week when I would be busy in a courtroom with a very important trial, doing the work the people of Oklahoma County elected me to do. Because of that important work, I'm unable to fully respond at this time.
Now, the claim was first filed in the state earlier this week, then in the county today. Gifford says that's because Prater is the attorney for the county, so it would be a conflict of interest for him to review it for the county. So he's requesting it be reviewed by the attorney general or an independent body. He's also requesting the attorney general do an audit of any grand jury subpoenas that have been sent to Prater to ensure those subpoenas have probable cause. Now, as far as Prater's comment about this being related to some sort of vendetta, Gifford tells me that's not what this is about. Kevin.